And I heard, as it were, the noise of thunder, one of the four beasts saying, "Come and see." And I saw, and behold, a white horse.
Hello folks, Johnny Cashflow here, and today I'm finally going to be putting out an edited commentary version of my video from Charlottesville. I know some people are thinking Charlottesville's done, it's over with, whatever, that's fine. But what I'm going to be talking about specifically is showing the tactics of Antifa in Charlottesville, showing how the fallout has affected Virginians in general. A lot of people don't think about this stuff, and seeing this all happen in my town and in my state is really giving me pause and making me think about all of the other issues and all the other flashpoints that we've seen, such as Dallas, for example, the Black Lives Matter attack where they killed four Dallas police officers. You know, how these impact communities and specifically legislators afterwards. And so we're gonna get into this. I'm also gonna try and cut it short, so that way it's easier to digest for everyone. All right, so without further ado, let's get into it. So first, we have the entry into the... We're gonna quiet this down a little bit before we start. So when we first start, you could see, you know, recording is different than being there live, right? So you first see this, and you see Antifa marching through, right? This is 2 hours before the actual speech was expected to take place. Okay, so I get here, I'm thinking I'm early. I'm just kind of setting up my camera and just thinking that I'm just going to walk around and just film this stuff. Again, what I have to stress to people is that before the Unite the Right rally happened on August 12th, there were two other rallies that occurred, which more or less went without too much notice, right? There was a KKK rally, which Black Lives Matter showed up, and from what I understand, some people were arrested for attacking the police officers. I believe that they were Black Lives Matter protesters were arrested. I'm not certain about this. I didn't follow that as closely as anything else. And then the other one was an alt-right where Richard Spencer came, gave a talk, and then left. And I did a video on this, basically explaining why the alt-right should be in favor of tearing down the statues and essentially, you know, related it to South Park. But there were no real big violent protests. So when everybody was setting up for this, I don't think anybody really realized how big this was. And we'll get into it and see that people were coming from out of state on both sides to cause violence. So in this situation, at this moment, I didn't even realize that what was going on in front of me as I was recording it was Antifa. I just, again, when you're there live, you don't understand the full context of the situation, and now looking back, I'm able to kind of understand it a little bit more. So let's get into it. And you can see the Antifa flag there. So again, this was 2 hours prior, and I know I mentioned that, not to belabor the point, but essentially what I found out afterwards is that the police officers, from the reports that I've read, and from, so I'm waiting for the full information. I'm trying not to get into conspiracy theories or anything like that, but from what I understand, the police held up the alt-right from marching to this location. If you see on the right here, this is where they're supposed to speak, and I didn't know that. I just walked up here and found a clearing, an open area, and just to get set up. But they allowed and didn't prevent the Antifa from marching in. So they held back the people who had the permit to be there to speak, but allowed Antifa to go in and flood the area. This sets up the basically the powder keg which we later see. So I'm going to try my best to speed this stuff up. So these guys are already marching in. We see here, we can kind of see it was shaped almost kind of like a W. The police barricades were shaped almost kind of like a W. And they expect, so on the far side over here, what we'll see is a clearing. And then in the close side here, there was a clearing. And I think the idea was to have Antifa on one side and alt-right on the other, but the police didn't have any control over any of this. Right from the beginning. So, there was a lot of talk about Nazi flags, and what I try to tell people is that I only recall seeing one legit Nazi swastika flag. With that being said, I don't know what some of these other flags are. I don't know what some of these, you know, white nationalist flags are. I don't know them, so I could be ignorant about that. But I do know that I saw tons of communist flags being flown. I counted about 12 communist flags for one legit Nazi swastika flag. So I don't know what this flag is over here on the left, that red flag. I don't know what that is. You know, so for all I know, these are all related to Nazism, and I don't know. But you got this one on the left, that's Blue Lives Matter, right? So it's kind of hard to discern the difference between some of these flags. This one in the middle, I don't know what that is. It looks kind of Germanic. I have no idea. So I will accept that my ignorance to some of this stuff. Alright. So Antifa's already working themselves up into a frenzy and chanting, right? The alt-right aren't even here. Yes, you could say that there are some maybe some racists here, you know, people with Confederate flags. I don't believe that the Confederate flag is inherently racist. I've lived in the South my entire adult life, and I've met plenty of black people, white people, everybody who's proud of their Southern heritage. I'm from California, so I don't have anything like that. But you know, so it's not. I don't see the Confederate flag as inherently racist, personally. We're gonna. All right. So now we're gonna fast forward.
Thank you. Appreciate it. Thank you.
Okay. So yeah. So there are people handing out water, which was cool. So here I am, and a lot of people may question, why did you go over there? Why did you do this? Again, I didn't really, when you're there live, I didn't notice that was Antifa marching. You know, I thought there was just a group of people, you know, like I had just got there, broke out my camera, and just started walking around. So the idea was I was just going to walk around and see what was going on. Again, I was 2 hours early, so I was just checking out the space. So I'm walking around. Okay, look at all those socialist flags. All right. Again, I saw a lot more socialist flags and communist flags with hammer and sickles than I saw Nazi flags. But of course, you know, socialism and communism is good, and Nazism is inherently evil. As you'll hear me say, I think they're both two sides of the same coin, but... So there's a legit hammer and sickle. This guy, I think this is the guy who ends up attacking me. We'll get into that. No, it's not. I was wrong. So I'm just walking around, just seeing what the security is like. I'm just kind of walking around here. Filming, and I say, okay, this is the end of it. And we'll get into these guys with the rifles here in a bit, but... So this guy right here, this tough guy right here, he's the guy who attacks me from behind. So I'm just here, just filming. I'm right next to ACLU people, you know, they're taking photos and stuff, so am I. Now... Again, people, I got into it with Bubblehead Bob, who is no longer on my streams. One of the reasons why it took me so long to get to making this commentary video is because him and I actually had a huge falling out. He has always claimed to be, you know, a classical liberal, but he must be low on tea and just heavy on the soy, because when I shared this information with him and told him that I was attacked or whatever, his response was essentially good, that I deserve to be attacked for carrying, and his words were, for carrying a symbol of white supremacy, which he was referring to my Kekistani flag that I was carrying. This is another reason why I mirrored Jeff Holliday's video of what is Kekistan, because, you know, people don't understand, and that's fine, but to just say, oh, you know, it's good that you were attacked, that's what he said, that's what I get for carrying a symbol of white supremacy is what he said to me. And other people, when I explained to them that I was carrying a Kekistani flag, you know, they kind of see it as, well, then you weren't there as an impartial observer, and that's fine. Okay, you know, like I. They're like, what was your intent in going there? Well, my intent in going there was the same intent as some of the other people there, and that it was to go there, listen to what they had to say. As I said in my last video, you know, I wish I had gone there to the first one, you know, because I had to find out that Richard Spencer is actually a socialist, is not of the right. He's actually a socialist by listening to his interview with Rumming Millennial. You know, so the more we actually listen to these people, the more we could say, oh, wait, you call yourself the alt-right, but you're actually a freaking socialist, so that's not right-wing, dude. So let's go through this. This guy is the guy who attacks me from behind, but, you know, he kind of starts blocking my way. You'll see, you know, once I realize that he's, you know, he's here trying to cause issue or whatever, I decide that I'm just going to walk back to the other side. So notice I didn't say anything to him. I'm just walking back. Okay, I'll walk back to where I started. Okay. Okay. What you'll see the camera jerk here in a sec, and it's him grabbing my flag. There you go. So he's grabbing my flag. I just keep trying to walk away. Mind you, also I'm outside their little ring of people, right? I'm walking on the outside. It's not like I'm walking through the middle of them trying to cause shit, okay? You know, and again, the looking at this from hindsight is different than being there in the moment, okay? So they assault me. My camera, my phone drops. I'm using my camera phone. The phone drops, and a person and another the Antifa member comes in and starts stomping on it. Okay, so they're stomping on it, and he stands on it. So I do want to make a quick shilling for OtterBox. I have an OtterBox on my phone. Highly recommend it. It saved my phone. Okay, so now here we are. Oh. Oh, okay, so this person, first person that I want to talk about. This person's name is Allie, is the name that she goes by. Here she is mocking me for being attacked. Okay, here she is, she was on my thumbnail, and it just so happened that, yeah, so she's mocking me openly for being attacked. Okay, what am I doing? I'm sitting here saying, so here I am advocating for debate and civil debate, right? And they're mocking me for. Yeah, what's your point? They're just starting. Come on. Oh, Nazi. Oh, that's. So they're advocating for violence against me. Okay, they're mocking me. They're laughing at me for being attacked, right? When I'm sitting here saying, you know, We need to have arguments and debate. Well, what happened to Allie? Allie was later hit by the Dodge Charger psychopath. Whatever the hell his name is. I can't remember. I don't know. Whatever, right? So, you advocate for violence. You had an opportunity to not be violent. To have debate. To have an argument. But now, what happens when you escalate it, right? So, she's made fun of me. She mocked me for being assaulted. And here she is, after the fact, being carted away for being after being injured. Now, I'm very conflicted by this. I take no joy in seeing people injured. I take no joy in this. But there's definitely a sense of irony, a sense of, kind of, I told you so, you know, because I haven't really been following the proceedings. I know that they keep trying to move the legal proceedings for whatever the hell his name is, freaking, we'll call him Douche Nozzle McKilling Face or something, you know, I know that they're trying to move it. They're trying because he wants a fair trial, et cetera, right? I think he needs to be punished by the fullest extent of the law. I cannot overstate that. But I am willing to bet, money that what actually occurred was he showed up to this event as a, I think he was part of the white nationalist parade or whatever. And I'm willing to bet that he was assaulted by Antifa. Got smacked up the head or whatever, was assaulted, got butt hurt by it, and then escalated, left, went, got into his car, and then drove it into this group. I'm willing to bet that that's what actually happened. Okay, and this is what happens when you have people who say, hey, let's talk, and then the next group says, no, we're not going to talk to you. We're going to attack you. And we've all seen the Professor Giraffe, what is his name, Isaacson, you know, come on and advocate for violence against people whom he disagrees with politically. We've seen this time and time again with Antifa, and I'm reading the Antifa handbook now, that they openly advocate for violence. So when you openly advocate for violence and you commit violence against people, it's only a natural progression that it's going to escalate. All right. So this chick now, Bowie, Wednesday Bowie, what a freaking hippie name. This is her. She comes up with a GoFundMe page. All right. So now she has a GoFundMe page because she was hit by this white nationalist. Right. And she's seen as a victim. She's not a victim. Just an hour earlier, she was mocking me for being attacked, and she was part of the group that attacked me, for just walking around with a Kekistani flag on, right? But again, the irony of all of this is great, because when we scroll down. What we see is one of her donors is Friends of Socialism. So let's get this straight. So Allie, who couldn't pay for her hospital bills, goes onto a GoFundMe website, which is capitalism, to ask for donations, which Friends of Socialism is more than happy to provide. $170 towards her medical bills. So what you're saying is that we don't need the government to provide healthcare because capitalism will take care of it through the non-forced, non-coerced generosity of others. Thanks, guys. I do appreciate that little win. I'll take that. I'll take that little bit. Thanks. So let's move on. Okay, so now we get into these guys. Why are you protected? I didn't even know what the heck was going on. You get attacked from behind, by a group of people. You're, you know, You're a little discombobulated. So I wasn't really sure what the heck they were talking about. They were talking about these guys. These guys are Oath Keepers. Now, I didn't know who the Oath Keepers were. I was pretty ignorant about it. And they've got mixed reviews, I'll say, from a lot of people that I've talked to about them. Some people think that they're great, you know, and I could see I can see the positives in them. You know, they're former military members, former law enforcement, who kind of make up I don't like to use the term militia because they don't like to use the term militia, but essentially they see that their oath to the Constitution, which I've sworn, they swore, everybody's sworn who's been in the military, to uphold and defend the Constitution against all enemies, foreign and domestic, they see that as a call that they're continuing along, even though they're not still officially in the military, okay? Some people call them a bunch of tryhards, you know, that they're just trying to relive their glory days or whatever. That's fine, whatever, you're entitled to your opinion. But notice that what they're doing is they're just separating, right? So I'm attacked.
That's a great argument that you had there.
So I'm attacked, and all what they did was they stepped in and separated. Again, I didn't know what was going on. You know, I'm focusing on these people who just attacked me. You can hear the guy in the background. You know, hey, just go. You know, we don't need this. You know, we don't need this. This is all before all the craziness. Okay, but you know, what's he trying to do? He's trying to de-escalate the situation. Okay. Cool down, calm down, you know, like he's trying to de-escalate the situation, right? We can all agree on that.
They're here. Well, go somewhere where they're not so live, man. You don't need to trouble. I'm just recording. Just keep going. I'm just recording. That's okay. Just keep going. Okay?
So, I'm pretty heated at this moment because I was just attacked. Okay? So, they had the cooler head. I'll admit that, right? I mean, again, I was literally just attacked from behind. So.
You don't need any trouble. They're the one who attacked me. I was just walking through.
Okay? We have a medic.
I appreciate it. Cheers.
You okay?
Yeah, but I'm definitely gonna put on my helmet now after being attacked.
Yeah, so I brought a helmet. I didn't think I was gonna need it, but okay. So these guys, Oath Keepers, okay. What did they do? They were trying to de-escalate the situation, right? Clearly, they're armed. Okay. A lot of news outlets spoke out against them. But what are they doing? They're de-escalating the situation. They're like, oh. People, you know, these crazy militias with open carrying are intensifying the situation, or, you know, blah, blah, blah. Really? So, what do we see later? And this is kind of what I was getting to is we see which one is this one? This is SB 665, right? In Virginia, where politicians are now trying to take away our open carry. So they're targeting, the Oath Keepers for the events that occurred, during this. So this is out of the, I'm reading out of the Daily Progress, which is a local Charlottesville paper, says Senator, Cray Deeds, Democrat from Bath, has filed several gun restriction bills in the wake of the ill-fated events of the Unite the Right rally in August. One of them, SB 665, is similar in language to Delegate Dave Toscano's HB 1009. Both bills seek to make open carry of certain firearms, including automatic weapons, unlawful in the city of Charlottesville and Albemarle counties. All right, so that's what the Daily Progress, which has a surprise, surprise, very progressive bent to it, says. But let's read the actual language. It shall be unlawful for any person to carry a loaded semi-automatic centerfire rifle or pistol that... Okay, so basically any semi-automatic rifle or pistol with a magazine that holds more than 20 rounds or designed by the manufacturer to accommodate a silencer or a folding stock. Or a shotgun with a magazine that will hold more than 7 rounds, to carry publicly, to have them carry on a street, road, alley, sidewalk, whatever, in the town. So they're using the events that occurred, a Unite the Right rally. They saw these Oath Keepers, and they say, "Oh well, we can't have open carry in Charlottesville." So they're using that to push against open carry laws. All right. Secondly, next we have Now this is where things get really dumb. SB 667. Okay. Any locality may pass an ordinance to regulate, restrict, or prohibit the wearing of any combination of attire or weaponry commonly associated with military combat, paramilitary operations, or warfare that gives a reasonable person the impression that the wearer is an on-duty member of the United States Armed Forces, an official law enforcement agency, or the militia during any permitted assembly of persons or movement of persons or vehicles if such attire constitutes a threat to the public safety or welfare. So, essentially what they're saying is that these guys can't wear camouflage. Likely the camouflage that they were issued, right? These guys can't look this way. Okay, you're not allowed to look a certain way. You're not allowed to wear clothing that looks a certain way. All right. So now they're regulating what clothes you can wear. All right.
Oh yeah.
So I make it no secret that I'm against both groups, right? So what we find all throughout this is that people want to tell me what my flag stands for. They want to tell you what you stand for. All right, that's what Bubblehead Bob did to me, right? Bubblehead Bob said that I was carrying a symbol of white supremacy, right? All these people want to tell you what you represent. Very few people, and I actually ended up turning off the camera for a lot of them, very few people asked me what does that mean? What does that represent? These people all want to just ascribe onto you what XYZ means.
Very, very mature response there. I think that them and you are the two sides of the same hateful coin. Okay. Yeah, what?
Here's the second douche nozzle who attacks me. Great fucking pants. You could tell that he has no fucking balls.
Kablong to attack me?
Yeah. So here I say, So basically saying that you disagreeing with me gives you carte blanche to attack me.
Yeah, I'm against identitarian politics. That's what I'm against. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Very, very mature response there. I think that them and you are the two sides of the same hateful coin. Okay. Yeah, what? Oh, does it give you carte blanche to attack me?
Yeah. Oh. So here he agrees. Yes. Yeah. It gives him the right to attack me. He just said it.
Oh, really? So you can just attack somebody because I'm carrying around a flag? Because you're a fucking racist piece
of shit. Then I ask him how. Can't answer. But he's gonna attack me.
Racist. How am I racist? Explain how I'm racist. How?
You're a fucking white supremacist piece of shit.
How am I white supremacist? Explain
yourself.
You're
a fucking white supremacist.
Give me an example. Give me an example. How am I being
Give
racist?
Give you an example.
Yeah.
You know how you're doing. You know.
That's what they always say. You know. No. Tell me. Because they can't. They can't tell you. They can't answer you. So they attack. They can't. They can't say how you're racist.
Don't touch my shit.
So then he attacks me. Somebody was nice enough to pick up my phone and hand it back to me.
Thank you, sir. Appreciate it.
So here's the only time that I saw the police actually get involved in anything was when I was being attacked. And what does he say?
You're causing me a lot of problems.
Well, I apologize.
You're causing me a lot of problems. Not the people who are attacking me are causing him a lot of problems, right? Not the people who come up to me, who attack me from behind. Not the people who come up and say, yeah, you know, because I disagree with you, that gives me the right to attack you. Not those guys aren't giving him the problems. It's me who are giving him the problems.
I'm just standing here.
Just go, please.
I will do it for you out of respect.
Thank you very much.
But notice that they attacked me. I was just standing here asking questions. How am I racist? I want to know how.
So you can hear other people saying the same thing. Don't touch me. Don't touch me. I'm just here. I'm just walking. I didn't notice. Anyways.
Where should I stand, sir?
I'm where you want, but I'm not going to babysit you all day.
No, that's fine.
So don't be out here causing problems.
Sir, with all due respect, I wasn't causing problems.
Notice how they blame me. How am I causing problems? We've all seen the video. How was I causing problems? How, you know, that's their perspective. Is that if they attack you, then you're the one who caused problems, right? We see this with all the speakers, having to charge for security fees, right? Antifa attacks and riots at Berkeley, so therefore anybody who for Milo Yiannopoulos or Ben Shapiro or whomever, you know, so therefore the people who want to host those people are now responsible for the behavior of other people. They're the ones who are causing problems. You know, you're the one who causes the problems by inviting Ben Shapiro to your college. You know, so therefore you need to pay for security. Not, hey, maybe these fucking pieces of shit shouldn't actually cause riots and attack people.
I was just trying to record the whole thing, and then somebody attacked me from behind.
I just watched.
Yeah.
Talking to people.
What? Talking to people is now I guess illegal or wrong or something.
He approached me.
And did he not approach me? Did the guy not approach me? I stood still and the guy approached me and got up in my face and attacked me.
I appreciate that. No, you don't. No, absolutely.
All right. Have a good day.
You have a better one, sir.
Again, these are things that you notice afterwards. These guys, these Oath Keepers are actually standing between me and the group or whatever. You know, so anybody who says anything negative about them, hey man, they were pretty legit here. You know, even we'll get into more stuff, but even you see they were you know, craziness broke out, and you know, at any time these guys, you know, they want the media and these legislators want to brand these guys as being just these wild, crazy militia guys who are just there to cause violence or whatever. Like at any time, did any one of them pull up a rifle? Did any one of them draw their pistol? Did any one of them ever threaten violence or you know, like they're not. They're just trying to do their best to try and help keep the peace. Because obviously the police, that was the only time that you see the police get involved in anything, in any of the other events later on. All right. So let's fast forward here. So this guy.
No, it's not. No, I reject all identitarian politics. That's all I do.
Is this really the way you want to live your life?
So this guy, you can look it up. This guy, this fat fuck.
How's that? I'm here. Exactly.
This guy, he comes up. Is this really the way you want to live your life? Is this really the way you want to live your life? Like the next day or 2 days later or whatever, you can look this up. I didn't prep well enough. But this guy actually assaulted Jason Kessler during a public speaking event or whatever. Jason Kessler, surrounded by police officers, this guy actually assaulted him while he was just speaking and talking about the charges brought against him and stuff. Again, not defending Jason Kessler's views or ideology at all. Just simply pointing out the facts. This guy wants to make a moral judgment against me But then he later goes on and assaults a person while they're just giving a press conference.
Exactly doing the same thing that you're doing, right? So what? So what? How am I living? Please explain it to me.
See, nobody can explain it. They just call you racist. They just nobody can actually say any of it.
Explain it to me. Tell me. I want to know. I'm not. I'm just sitting here asking questions.
I'm here today to be angry, but all I am now is sick.
I think it's very telling that he openly admits that he came there to be angry. Like, I didn't come here to be angry.
You came here to be angry?
And now all I am is sick.
Well, I'm sorry, dude.
You guys burned the anger out of
him. Did you what? I'm sorry, I can't.
They burned the anger out of him. But he had enough the next day to assault Jason Kessler during a press conference.
I really can't hear you.
That was a good, yeah, she's right.
That's actually pretty rational.
Yeah.
But I like to just talk to people.
All right, so let's fast forward.
I'm just trying to ask people questions.
You
want to answer questions?
This guy, that was
Lynn. That's very nice of you to offer.
So then I get assaulted again. So notice that even more people are showing up. Antifa and Black Lives Matter show up. So again, the police allow these guys to show up, but they're holding back. Again, I didn't find out about this, and correct me if I'm wrong. If I'm wrong, but this is what I understood from the reports later on, was that they held back the white nationalists from being able to get to the area that we saw earlier. All right. So they allow them to work themselves up into a fervor. All communist flags. All right. So some guy comes up and hits me in the head with my helmet on. I tell people I was technically assaulted like 3.5 times. Cause does that really count that somebody walks by and then hits you in the head if you have a helmet? I don't know. Legally, yes, but I mean, let's be honest. I'm not gonna cry about it. But just pointing that out. All right. So here they are. They're all working themselves up into a fervor. So here. Did I miss it? I may have missed it. But basically, I may have missed it. Oh no. Okay. So some white nationalists were lining up, I guess. Trying to point out. Oh, here's a guy. So this guy, something tells me that this guy was taking photos to put me on some hate board or whatever. Something tells me that I'm a target somewhere. This guy was way too nice.
Bring it in, folks. All right, buddy.
But I tried being nice. So I mean, I look back on this and just think this guy probably went to put my face up on some Antifa blog or something. I'm sure. But if that is the case, notice, you know, I'm trying to be polite. I'm trying to be nice to everybody. But if that's not the case, then I misjudged him, and he seemed like a nice guy. Hashtag not all.
No, man. I was just came in here to ask questions and talk to people, man.
You and me both.
Okay, here's. Okay, so here are these guys. These Antifa pieces of shit come up and they start threatening me. Again, I'm just standing here, right? Am I starting shit? I mean, I just took a picture with somebody who had an anti-Trump shirt on. Not that I'm pro-Trump. I'm just not anti-Trump either. But you know, you approach me and we could be nice. We could have a debate. We could have a rational discussion. But what do these pieces of shit do? So these two guys come up to me and just start talking shit, right? And then they threaten me and threaten to beat me up later when they come back with their group, because they couldn't do it by themselves there. Mind you, I'm a small dude. But I think a lot of people that actually lends to my benefit, because a lot of people underestimate me.
Why?
Because you're a fucking Nazi.
I am.
What does that say right there?
there.
Keck Lives Matter. Keck Lives Matter. How's that?
Get the fuck out of here.
Why is that? Why is it that you guys are the only ones who are hostile
to us? No, listen, we're not fucking debating with you. You got 10 seconds to get the fuck out of here.
What happens then?
Go walk.
Why? What happens then?
Get the fuck out of here right now.
I love it. I love it. Get the fuck off our streets. That's what they always say. This is our, get the fuck off our streets. These are our, whose streets? Our streets. I wonder if these people are even from Charlottesville. I wonder if these people are even local. I'm wondering if these guys got bussed in from freaking New York or Berkeley or something. Alright, so here we go. Whoa. Darn it. Alright, so let's back up. Oh, where'd they go? Darn it. Damn it. Sorry, the being able to scroll is difficult. But so then we have these guys. Let's talk about these guys. So up here on the left, we're gonna try and pause it real quick. There. All right. So here, up here, we have these people who look to be like clergy members. Where are they? Here we go. All right. So these people walk arm in arm as clergy members to counter protest. No problem, right? Like, that's great. Like, I would love to see non-violent protests like this, no problem, okay? The problem comes in, though, and I was talking with a friend of mine who is pretty, I guess, pretty knowledgeable, pretty ingrained in the local religious community. So he knew some of these people, and they told him that that they just went there and peacefully protested, right? Peacefully, right? But what they don't mention is, what they didn't mention is that they actually formed a human wall to prevent, these are the stairs that the white nationalists were expected to walk up into, all right? And I don't know if I have video of that. So essentially, you're not peacefully protesting, you're actively preventing people from legally, because they have a permit, protesting. Okay, so they have the permit, you do not, therefore they have a right to be there, you do not, and so you cannot prevent their permitted, their right to speak by preventing them from getting to their point. So essentially, the white nationalists, again, not defending their ideology, I'm not defending their ideology, again, third time, not defending their ideology, but when you force them to have to go through you to get to the place that they are have a permit to speak and the police don't intervene, then it's not their fault. They are not to blame for any violence that occurs. You are the one that is trying to prevent them from getting to that point, right? So, and had you not stood in their way and built a human wall, then no issue would have occurred. There wouldn't have been an altercation, okay? But this is the picture that was in the newspaper. What you don't have is them preventing the white nationalists from getting to where they are permitted to speak. All right, so some dude comes up and says he wants to interview me. So I talk to him. I'm explaining Kekistan to him. Meanwhile, the white nationalists are actually showing up. Okay, so what I'm not paying attention to, what I don't realize is that behind us here in this photo, mind you, here's the guy who attacked me earlier. He walks around the whole time, looking for his chances to cause violence. So behind me, the white nationalists are actually marching in now. So what we'll see here,
put a gun up to my head and say,
what we see here is that the is Antifa are then go and confront them. Okay, so that's what we're seeing. All right. So the white nationalists are trying to get to the place where they're supposed to talk, right? Remember earlier where I said this is the designated area, right? So and Antifa goes and tries to block their way. Now, clearly I didn't see what happened, what instigated it, what started it. I don't know. Okay? What I do know is, generally speaking, again, not defending ideology, just talking about the facts of what occurred. Generally speaking, what I witnessed was that the white nationalists brought shields, generally speaking, and the Antifa brought sticks. All right? And I think that's telling. We see sticks, and the white nationalists brought shields and pepper spray. Now, did some of them have, I'm saying generally speaking. Now, we see them with sticks, so maybe I just didn't pay attention enough. I'm open to new information, but generally speaking, you know, I think it's telling that you have some people bringing shields and other people just bringing sticks. There's Antifa flags, communist flags. Again, look for the... So, I don't know what happened. This happened behind me, but people are getting violent. I'm trying to defuse the situation. So, I think the white nationalists brought the pepper spray. I also witnessed Antifa bring pepper spray as well. But again, if Antifa had not formed, had not been allowed to form, or had been separated from the parading route that the police made the white nationalists come through, then we wouldn't have had these altercations. Yes, this is looking at it through hindsight, but even at the time, I'm like, this doesn't make sense. All right, let's move forward. See, like this flag, I don't know what the X flag, I don't know what that means. You know, it's probably some white nationalist flag, I don't know. But notice how I'm like, I don't know. I'm not saying, oh, they're definitely a Nazi who wants to eradicate all the Jews or whatever, right? It may be, but I'm not ascribing to them a belief.
You okay? You need some water?
This guy. So I've actually seen this guy around town, and I see him come out. He got pepper sprayed, so I stopped to help him out. Okay. Now then, he gets pepper sprayed. Okay. What does he do then after that? Let's see if I... Nope, wrong one. Which one? Here we go. He then goes on to hurl water bottles at the white nationalists. All right, so what's my point? My point is that he continues the violence, right? And this is ultimately the same motivation that I think that psychopathic piece of shit freaking Dodge Challenger driver. I probably should look up his name. I have no freaking idea. Whatever. That dude's, we'll just keep calling him the psychopathic piece of shit. It's the same mentality, right? It's the same thing, right? He was attacked and then he goes back. You could tell that this is afterwards because his shirt's wet, right? And he goes back and continues the violence, right? And so this is the same thing, the same mentality that the psychopathic driver did. The only thing is that this guy didn't ramp it up to 11. This guy kept it around 7, right? So to think that, and I know I call him the psychopathic Dodge Challenger driver because he is a psychopathic Dodge Challenger driver, not defending him, and not accusing this guy. I'm just simply talking about when violence escalates,
then there has to be somebody who says, I'm not going to further this escalation. And it seems to me like the only group that refuses to say that we need to stop this escalation is the Antifa, these communists. Look at all these socialist communist flags. I mean, those are all socialist communist flags. Well, I don't know what that rainbow one is. I don't know, but I think we could venture a guess. Okay. All right. So, fighting. All right. So you see that they made their way through the barrier, but I did witness. There's the chick from InfoWars. She gets assaulted. I've got her on video being assaulted. See, so like what's that black and white flag with whatever the hell that is? You know, like I get the cross one. I've seen that before. But notice no legit Nazi flags. Okay? Like you could say that these are white nationalist flags, these other flags. I will still contend that the stars and bars, as they say, or the Confederate flag is not inherently racist. Not inherently racist. That's not to say that racists don't fly them. That's not to say that also people who aren't racist fly them. All right. So inherently, I would argue that it's not racist. Some of these other ones, yes, probably. But if we want to, you know, but if we want to collectivize everybody, then we could do that. I'm against that, but we could do that. And then just say that everybody who was counter-protesting that day is a violent communist who wants to, you know, send all the kulaks into the gulags. And I didn't mean for that to rhyme, but, you know. Like, when we collectivize everybody. All right, let's fast forward. Here the police actually get involved to... Okay, so I stand corrected. So they did get involved this one time. Again, I'm open to be.
Green shirt was yelling at the cops, presumably over them not doing anything for the little fight that just broke out.
So all of this could have been avoided. All of this could have been avoided, had they segregated Antifa and the white nationalists, had they had designated areas or I don't know, just not let the white nationalists freaking hold them back to have to parade through a violent mob. Just, you know, hindsight, you know, Captain Hindsight over here. But what else we got? Let's try to get through some of this stuff. I had to change because I was losing battery pretty quickly. I wasn't prepped for any of this. So again, this is me. I start conversations with random people. I do want to say, oh, real quick, want to give a shout out to the people at the Steven Crowder Live. I'm gonna do another video on that. You know, make friends, people. Make friends. Talk to people, man. That's the better. You know, the more we talk. All right, let's move on. Moving on. So both sides were throwing stuff. Both sides were spraying each other with pepper spray. All right. What I also want to dispel is this idea that there were two sides, right? You had the white nationalists and Antifa. And I know I kind of perpetuated a little bit with some of the language that I use, but some of the people, if you watch the original, you can see. The people I was talking to, there were hippie women, these two hippie, older women. You could just tell by talking with them that they were, you know, lifelong Democrats. Okay. They were like old school hippies. Okay. And what we were talking about was that they were actually in favor of keeping the monument, which is just, I don't know, we could talk about that for hours, but I thought it was interesting that you have people who are lifelong Democrat voters, hippies, who are in favor of keeping the monument. You know, I and many other more astute people will say, well, sure, because, you know, Democrats are the true racist, you know, party of racism, blah, 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 whatever. Okay, but my point is that, you know, there were nuances to this. There were people there with nuanced views that never got covered, never got covered, never got reported on. I'm trying to find a good volume for us to talk about this. All right. So. Okay, so there's a Black Lives Matter New York sign. So let's see one of these. Is it this one? No. All right. Well, we'll get to this guy later. Sorry for keep showing him up. We'll get into that. All right. So here we go. This is a photo that I found online. All right. This guy was walking around with a picture of Barack Obama sexually molesting what's his name, the dude that he's married to. All right. So, what the fuck does any of this have anything to do with anything? Like, this whole rally was supposed to be about keeping the monument. Okay, the Robert E. Lee monument. Okay? And here are people from out of town. You could see, or out of state, all these signs. It's kind of hard to see. But these signs aren't local. That sign, Black Lives Matter, these signs right here are Black Lives Matter New York. Okay, that's where these guys were from. These guys were from New York City. Okay? So no shit that they showed up and caused violence, because they don't give a fuck about our town. They don't give a fuck about Charlottesville. They don't give a fuck about the freaking, the statues. They see it as a political tool, you know? So they're coming from out of state to cause violence. Same thing with, if you watch the Vice video covering Chris Cantwell, right? The Vice video, I watched it once. It was okay, I guess. But you know, you can't trust Vice. Let's face it. It'd be just like from HuffPo or anybody else, you know. But you know, in the video he talks about, yeah, hey, who came the farthest? Let's talk about, you know, who came here the farthest. And people were shouting out, you know, they were from North Carolina, they were from South Carolina, they were from Kansas, they were coming from Tennessee or whatever. People were coming from out of state. So when people come from out of state to someplace that they're not from, then they're more likely, more prone, I'd be willing to bet. I'm sure there's some sort of data out here that could justify this argument, that they're more prone to cause violence. You know, if you go to Boston, would you care as much if you piss somebody off in Boston than if you did in your own local neighborhood? You know, if you got into a fight, I'm assuming you're not from Boston, or, you know, I say Boston because Boston's pretty far from me, but, like, you know, if you go somewhere else in America, you know, and are in this kind of a situation, you're less likely to give a damn, unless, of course, you're from Baltimore, which they just burn and blow up everything anyways, their own shit, so. Alright. So then the police declare that this an unlawful assembly. It's finally gotten to this point. And there's a lot of conspiracy theories, and there was a I didn't read the report. Damn it, I need to do more prep work for this shit. But there was a report that came out I think it was a state report or maybe it was a federal report. I don't know, but that interviewed a police officer who admitted that the point of it was to not police anything, to let it get out of control, and then shut it down. And if you take it as just face value, if you take it and you look at this, you could see where and how that could be accurate. See, I'm such a hateful person. I just have. Let's talk about where's this dude at. See it. Slowly make my way back. So let's try and fast forward through some of this. All right, so here we have people from Black Lives Matter coming in and throwing shit at the police. You know, they come up and yell "fuck the police" here. Here's this guy. Oh man, where have I seen that guy before? You think maybe I might have a picture of him somewhere around here? Nope, not there. We'll get to that one too. Oh, look at this guy. Oh. So fuck the police, but I'm gonna make a homemade freaking flamethrower and cause violence. Oh. Okay, I love this old white guy. sorry, folks, but this photo, it's you know, you see it if you pay attention to the fallout stuff. This photo has been out there for a while, but I just love the guy on the right here who's just he's so out of place. He has no idea what he's doing here. Oh, poor guy. So what else? Man, that's funny. All right, so then we have him. Is this? I can't tell if this is the same guy. I don't think it is. I don't think it's the same guy. But what we have here now? This event happened after I left. Okay, and this is me editorializing. This is me just kind of just trying to piece some things together. All right, because we do have some stuff that came out of here. So what we have here is a photo. And I'm basing this all off of two photos, and I don't care about any of the testimony until it's fully done. When the testimony and all of the trial is done, then I'll look at the testimony and I'll make a more informed decision. But right now, all I'm saying is that here, what we have, what looks like these guys were assaulted. Okay, the white nationalists, looks like the white nationalists were assaulted by the people on the right. Okay. He's got his flag, right? The guy's coming up with a bat, and he's being maced. The way that they're standing. Okay, now this is just coming from my 12 years of intel experience. Don't, you know, take it for what it's worth, but just the way that these guys, the way that their bodies are positioned. It looks like the guys on the left are in a defensive position, and the guys on the right are in an offensive position. Okay, that they are assaulting them. Okay, then we have, this scenario where, again, I'm working off of limited information, but we have what was a, I think it's DeAndre Harris. So right back here, if you can see behind these guys is a parking structure, and that's where we're seeing facing each other. Okay, so this is in the parking structure looking back. This is outside the parking structure looking forward. All right. So it looks like I'm making an assumption here, okay? I don't know, but I would venture a guess that these guys were assaulted and they pulled him back, you know, and somehow the scuffle or whatever moved back into here where DeAndre Harris was beat. Not making excuses. And this is totally, I'm open to new information. I don't know, okay? Why am I saying this? Why, you know, where do I pull this? Do I have any kind of evidence? Not really, but what I do have are my experience and what I see here. Okay? Fuck the police until we get cornered in a parking lot, parking garage. And then you know, we need the government and we need the laws to be on our side. Okay? I don't know anything about DeAndre Harris, but I'm sure he would have wanted the police officers to be in that parking garage at that moment. Just saying. All right, so let's fast forward, try and get through some of this stuff. There was this guy. I'm trying to find him. I'm not doing a very good job here, but basically this guy comes up. Where was he at? Not that guy. Not that guy. Not that guy. That guy. All right. So this guy on the left here, in the wife beater, behind the guy who's beating the guy on the ground, because, you know, nothing says, you know, we want peace like beating a guy on the ground. I don't know anything that happened here. I have no idea. I've got no background information. For all I know, the guy on the ground assaulted the guy on the top first. Don't know. But I am willing to give him the benefit of the doubt since he is on the ground and being beat mercilessly. But the guy behind him is the guy, if you watch the original video, I can't seem to find it. I'm not trying to take up too much of the time. But he's like, he comes in, he says that he's a law student at UVA. And then he walks away, says, no, I don't want to be filmed. And I'm like, well, you're in a public place. And he walks away, okay? We also see this guy in the photos. Not that one. We also see him here with his back turned behind the creepy photo of Michael and Barack Obama. Okay, what he did was he came up to me. I was a woman, a female priest or clergy member was asking me about my flag, and I was explaining it to her. And he came up and was just like, "Oh, he's a fucking Nazi. He's a fucking piece of shit." Blah blah blah. And she goes, "I wish I would have recorded this because she goes to him and she's like, excuse me, I'm talking to him, and you're using foul language that I don't appreciate." It was great. It was absolutely great. And she then thanked me for my time, and I thanked her for hers. And then he kept trying to talk to me, and so I turned off my camera while talking to the woman, which I wish I would have not done. But then he turned around and walked away. But what he has a Star of David on his arm, and he comes up to me. He's like, "See this?" And I'm like, "Yeah." And he's like, "You know what that means, right?" I'm like, "Sure." Like, okay. And he's like, and he was so proud of this Star of David on his arm, but didn't want to talk to me about it. The idea was that I just finished talking to the woman about how I'm against identity politics, but then he comes up and tries to say that I, you know, am against Jews for some reason, like, which is just not the case. All right, moving on. Finally, let's move it on. So then I try walking away. I'm leaving. All right, I'm out of here. Try and leave. Okay, all right, so I'm walking out. And some guy stops me and wants to ask me about my flag. I'm gonna turn up a little bit so you can kind of hear a little bit. So I'm just walking back to where I'd kind of stage
some stuff. So,
yeah, what's up?
So that's him. Hey, hey, buddy, let me ask you a question. Sure, what's up?
How you doing? What's up?
I greet him, say, hey, you know, yeah, handshake, right? Let's be cordial. Well, I didn't notice this fucktard right here who wants to fucking attack me, right? So here we have an opportunity to have a discussion. Here we have an opportunity where somebody's actually going to ask me about the Kekistani flag. Ask me, you know, maybe we can actually have some dialogue. Here, a black guy, mind you. I didn't know he was black when I turned around. What do I know, you know? And I, nothing against him. My point of bringing up his race is that kind of like what Owen Benjamin talks about, is that you have a black person who's like, hey man, let me ask you a question. And then you've got a white freaking piece of shit who wants to come and attack you, right? Who wants to call you a Nazi and shit, right? Who wants to say that you're racist. So I think that's kind of funny that here is actually what seems to be a pretty reasonable person who just happens to be black, right? I don't care about his race. My point is that he could be out there shouting "fuck the police," you know, with his shirt off and lighting fires to try and light up the white nationalists. But he instead says, "Hey, let me have a rational conversation with you. I'll be friends with that dude every day. We could disagree, and I will take that guy. He could be on my team. Okay, we could disagree on everything." Okay, but I'll take that guy on my team over the fucktards who are sitting there saying "fuck the police" or this piece of shit who was following me. Notice that he was following me. I turned around. He was gonna fucking attack me from behind, just like the other fucktards did. They can't fucking attack you from the front. So he attacks me. I get him off me. Then other people attack me from behind. So in my mind, immediately I'm thinking that this guy who said, "Hey man, let me ask you a question," was like on their side. I hate saying that, but like, you know, I in my mind, I just got set up. So I'm like, I'm ready to fucking start throwing blows. And this guy walks away, and in just a split second, you know, the guy's like, "No, get out of here, man. Go."
Great argument. You really showed me, man.
And here he is, trying to warn me, "Hey, there's somebody coming up behind me. Go, get out of here. Because somebody attacked me from behind." Again, they can't attack you from the front. They can't see you face to face, right? They have to attack you from behind.
Thank you.
And to show that I appreciated his efforts, because I wasn't afraid of these fucking kids. Like, fuck. Folks, I'm 120 pounds. Look at the size of that fucking dude. Like, I'm 120 pounds, all right? I'm a small fucking dude, all right? Sorry, I think I'm yelling at the phone. I'm a small dude. I'm 120 pounds. Look at this fucking dude, all right? What is this guy? 200 pounds? You think he's about 200 pounds? So let's just say, for the sake of argument, we'll say that we'll scale it down. We'll say he's 170, which I don't think. I think he's about 200 pounds, maybe even more than that. I'm really bad with weights. I don't know, but that's freaking 50, 60, 80 pounds, depending on how much he weighs, more than me. He's a full person. Weighs more than me, right? Can't take my shit. Fuck you.
What the fuck?
You can't take my shit. I'm able to retain my flag. Fuck you. Could it be maybe because I've protected more than one flag in my life? Just saying.
Great argument. You really showed me.
Then he runs off. And somebody else attacks me from behind.
Thank you.
And then again, to show that no hard feelings with this dude, who like I said, was a great dude. I shake his hand, say thanks, and walk off. Look at these fucking three of them. Three of them, and four, I think there was a fourth one next to him. Fucking don't do shit. They don't do shit. Like, I get it. I'm 120 pounds, man. I look like them. But they can't fucking do shit but attack me from behind. I fucking love it. Low T, man. I may be 120 pounds.
Have a logical debate.
I'm 120 pounds, but yet...
But yeah, I got more fucking testosterone than all of them bitches.
We can't just talk about things.
And I choose.
Civil discourse?
Note that I'm choosing to try and push civil debate. Okay, so let me finish with this. Let me finish on this, folks. All right, I'll admit it. Okay, I went to this thing thinking that I was going to listen to white nationalists. Okay, I thought I was going to listen to Jason Kessler talk about socialism, talk about, you know, all this shit that Richard Spencer talks about, right? I go there because I, as somebody who is right of center, feel the need to point out that the alt-right is not right, okay? They're not right of center. They are socialists, okay? That was my goal, okay? These people showed up and attacked me, okay? Little do these people fucking know, okay, I'm a concealed carry permit holder, all right? I had more than one firearm on me concealed at that event, okay? Legally, I was in my right to defend myself with deadly force from any of those attacks. Okay, the law states that I can use lethal force against any person who or any violent action against me, which I fear or have a reasonable fear of death or serious bodily injury. All right, that's what the law says. All right, so if I had a reasonable fear of serious bodily injury or my life, I had the right to pull my firearm and shoot any of them. Okay, so for all these lawmakers who say, "Oh, we need to ban open carry, we need to, you know, keep people from wearing camouflage," because, you know, that was the real threat here, right? Were the people who were wearing camouflage and who were open carrying, right? Antifa does not understand who they are messing with when they increase and escalate this violence. Okay, I'll tell you right now, folks, my line in the sand was if they managed to drop me like they did, where's he at, freaking, like they did the one dude that I showed you guys, was this guy, well, like that, or where is he at? Or like this. If I found myself in this situation, you better believe I am drawing and I am shooting your fucking ass. Alright? I didn't start fights. I didn't try to escalate fights. I didn't try to escalate the violence. Antifa is escalating the violence. And they don't understand who they're fucking with. Alright? I tried to have a rational debate. I've tried to have nice, sensible discussions, right? But the more that these people push violence instead of debate, the more they're going to end up like this chick, all right? Or whatever the hell she is, all right? Thanks for watching, folks. I appreciate it. Like and subscribe. Share. I'm long-winded. I get it. But I appreciate every single view. I don't do this for money. I do this just to try and get out the truth, get out information, and keep that discussion going, and just try and be part of the discussion. So every like, subscribe, share is greatly appreciated. And until next time, I got no sign out. Peace.
There's a man going round taking names, and he decides who to free and who to blame. Everybody won't be treated all the same. There'll be a golden ladder reaching down. when the man